Hello everyone, welcome to Cyber Skills 99 YouTube channel. In this video we will share information about most exploited vulnerabilities in 2022. Vulnerability number 1. Falloner, CV-2022-30190. Researchers have discovered another serious vulnerability in Microsoft products that potentially allows attackers to execute arbitrary code. MITRE designated this vulnerability as CV-2022-30190, while researchers somewhat poetically named it Falloner. The CV-2022-30190 vulnerability is contained in the Microsoft Windows Support Diagnostic Tool, MSDT, which doesn't sound like a big deal. MSDT is an application that is used to automatically collect diagnostic information and send it to Microsoft when something goes wrong with Windows. The tool can be called up from other applications, Microsoft Word being the most popular example, through the special MSDT URL protocol. The Falloner vulnerability can be exploited in all operating systems of the Windows family, both desktop and server. The most common way to do this is to send an email with the malicious attachment, spiced up with some classic social engineering trick to convince the recipient to open the file. Vulnerability number 2. Log4Shell, CV-2021-44228. The Log4Shell vulnerability is a remote code execution, RCE, vulnerability found in the Apache Log4j2 logging library. As Apache Log4j2 is commonly used by many software applications and online services, it represents a complex and high-risk situation for companies across the globe. Referred to as Log4Shell, CV-2021-44228, CV-2021-45046. It introduces a new attack vector that attackers can exploit to extract data and deploy ransomware in an organization. Vulnerability number 3. Spring4Shell CV-2022-22965. Spring4Shell is a vulnerability in VMware's Spring Core Java framework, an open-source platform for developing Java applications. Spring is a highly popular framework with 60% of Java developers depending on it for the production of their applications. Because of the framework's dominance in the Java ecosystem, many applications could potentially be impacted by the Spring4Shell's Hero Day. In comparison, the Log4j framework is used by almost all Java-based web apps and cloud services, so though Spring4Shell is categorized as a critical vulnerability, it's still significantly less dangerous than Log4Shell. Spring Core, often abbreviated as Spring, simplifies parameter extraction requests on an Apache Tomcat server or Java server. In other words, Spring makes writing and testing code easier by allowing developers to map user requests to Java objects. The Spring4Shell vulnerability allows attackers to exploit this pathway, making all connected applications vulnerable to remote code execution, RCE. Vulnerability number 4. Big API controlled REST vulnerability, CV-2022-1388. CV-2022-1388 is an authentication bypass vulnerability in the REST component of BigIP's iControl API. The iControl REST API is used for the management and configuration of BigIP devices. CV-2022-1388 could be exploited by an unauthenticated attacker with network access to the management port or self-IP addresses of devices that use BigIP. Exploitation would allow the attacker to execute arbitrary system commands, create and delete files, and disable services. Vulnerability number 5. Chrome Zero Day, CV-2022-0609. Google's Threat Analysis Group reported a zero-day vulnerability, CV-2022-0609, in Chrome that threat actors are currently exploiting in the wild. This flaw is a high-severity use-after-free vulnerability in the animation component of Chrome. This vulnerability affects all Chrome users, regardless of which OS is running. A use-after-free (UAF) exploit refers to memory after it has been freed, which can cause a program to use unexpected values, corrupt valid data, crash, or execute code, according to MITRE. Vulnerability number 6. Microsoft Office bug, CV 2017-11882. Microsoft Office 2007 Service Pack 3, Microsoft Office 2010 Service Pack 2, Microsoft Office 2013 Service Pack 1, and Microsoft Office 2016 allow an attacker to run arbitrary code in the context of the current user by failing to properly handle objects in memory, aka Microsoft Office Memory Corruption Vulnerability. Vulnerability number 7. Proxy Not Shell, CV 2022-41082. In late September 2022, Microsoft released information relating to two previously unknown zero-day vulnerabilities collectively known as Proxy Not Shell affecting Microsoft Exchange. The two vulnerabilities, CV 2022-41040 and CV 2022-41082, are known to impact Microsoft Exchange Server 2013, 2016, and 2019. Proxy Not Shell, according to Microsoft, is two vulnerabilities with, the first vulnerability, identified as CV 2022-41040, is a server-side request forgery, SSRF, vulnerability, while the second, identified as CV 2022-41082, allows remote code execution, RCE, when PowerShell is accessible to the attacker. Vulnerability number 8. Zimbra Collaboration, CV 2022-27925. Zimbra Collaboration, aka ZCS, the 8th of August 2015 and 9.0 has Mbox import functionality that receives a zip archive and extracts files from it. An authenticated user with administrator rights has the ability to upload arbitrary files to the system, leading to directory traversal. Vulnerability number 9. Atlassian Confluence RCE, CV 2022-26134. During their investigation, security research team discovered bash shells launched by Confluence. The team found that the web server process and its child processes created by the exploit were all running as the root, full privileges, user and group. Attackers with access to the shell were able to have complete control over the Confluence server. For instance, in one exploit, the attackers deployed an in-memory copy of the behinder implant that provides powerful capabilities to attackers, including memory-only web shells and built-in support for interaction with MetaPrinter and Cobalt Strike. Vulnerability number 10. Zycel RCE, CV 2022-30525. Rapid7 discovered and reported a vulnerability that affects Zycel firewalls supporting zero-touch provisioning, ZTP, which includes the ATP series, VPN series, and the USG Flex series, including USG 20 VPN and USG 20 WVPN. The vulnerability, identified as CV 2022-30525, allows an unauthenticated and remote attacker to achieve arbitrary code execution as the nobody user on the affected device. The affected firewalls are advertised for both small branch and corporate headquarter deployments. We hope you enjoyed this report on most exploited vulnerabilities in 2022. Thank you for watching. Please give the videos a like, subscribe, and spread the word.